President Obama recently announced his support for net neutrality, saying that we shouldn't throttle the internet speeds based on how much a corporation is willing to pay. But ultimately, the decision lies with Tom Wheeler, the chairman of the FCC, and he seems more than willing to destroy the public's main source of information. Joining me now to talk about net neutrality is Tim Karr, the Senior Director of Strategy for Free Press. Tim, you wrote a piece recently where you discussed the fact that President Obama, he's got these new incoming Republican majorities in the Senate and the House, a stronger majority in the House. So what are his options? Does he try to push forward with things that he's been attempting, or does he go for a completely new issue? And from what we've seen, it looks like he's maybe going to go after a couple new issues like net neutrality.
Well, yeah, certainly. It seems like now that he is free of midterm election concerns and now that he is free of re-election concerns, he has returned to some of the core issues from his campaign. That was his campaign back in 2008 when he made net neutrality certainly his signature telecom policy issue. So we saw earlier this month, Obama came out with a very strong statement in support of net neutrality. And he didn't just say he supports net neutrality, but he also called on the FCC to take specific action in order to get us there. So that was a pretty bold move from Obama, and we're seeing that he's doing this similar things on other issues, immigration reform, things of that sort. So this is a new face to the White House, and one that net neutrality supporters like my organization are happy to see.
And so one of the things he had suggested was regulating the internet as if it were a public utility. What exactly does that mean? If we made the internet a public utility, you know, what does that change, or what does that protect?
That wasn't his suggestion. That is actually the way that that's been interpreted. In fact, what he has been calling for is for internet service providers, companies like Comcast and AT&T and Verizon that sell us access, to fall under another category of regulations that would allow the FCC to prevent them from blocking content, from favoring certain content and websites over others, from degrading other websites. So what he was calling for was a regulation of internet service providers. And as we know, it's not a regulation of the internet. AT&T and Comcast are no more the internet than a company like Georgia Pacific or Weyerhaeuser are the forests.
Right.
And yet we have rules that prevent them from clear-cutting our national parks. And this is the same way of creating a legal structure that prevents these companies from censoring free speech. It protects internet users, and it preserves the openness of the internet as we've known it from its inception.
And when you bring up companies like AT&T and Comcast, it's important to point out that these are both, you know, very massive companies that have spent millions of dollars just this year alone already, you know, trying to lobby for this issue, because for them, getting rid of any kind of net neutrality, making users have to pay more to get their website going at a faster speed would be a huge payday for them. So how does that lobbying, all of this corporate money, we know what it does to elections, we know what it does to politicians. Do you think that's going to play a role in any of the decisions we may see coming?
Well, it has, and lobbying plays a role in almost any policy decision that's made in Washington. Net neutrality, we have this kind of weird situation where there are these opposite worlds. There's the Beltway and conventional wisdom inside Washington, where these companies have so much political power and financial clout, is that the FCC is not going to do what President Obama has asked them to do. But outside of the Beltway, we've had more than 4 million people comment at the FCC. There are more comments on this issue at the FCC than any other issue in the history of the federal agency that have said, we need strong net neutrality rules. They've endorsed what Obama has just endorsed, this Title II reclassification of internet service providers. So the grassroots, the netroots, the president now are telling Washington it needs to move in one direction. Now, the problem that we have is that the Federal Communications Commission is an agency that is often captive of corporate special interests. AT&T, Comcast, Verizon, they send their lobbyists up there on a daily basis. So it's our job, the job of my organization, Free Press, which organizes outside of Washington, to make sure that popular message is getting through in a way that will get this chairman, Chairman Tom Wheeler, the FCC chairman, to listen to the president and listen to the people instead of trying simply to please those very powerful corporate players.
And what has been Chairman Wheeler's position on everything so far? Is he looking like he may ignore the telecoms, or is he leaning towards their favor?
Well, he prior to being the chairman of the FCC, he was the top lobbyist for cable companies, and prior to that, he was the top lobbyist for wireless companies. So he has a close tie to the phone and cable lobby, but at the same time, he's also very loyal to President Obama. He was one of his top bundlers during both of the Obama campaigns, raised a lot of money for the president's election and reelection efforts. So he's kind of in this weird position where he's sort of split, and he's trying to do is split the baby. He used that sort of King Solomon reference. He said he wants to split the baby in a way that makes everybody happy. But anybody who's familiar with the King Solomon story is that splitting the baby makes nobody happy. You actually kill the baby, and nobody wants that outcome. So we're hopeful that he'll do the right thing here.
And most of these firms, Verizon and AT&T and Sprint, these are some of the same guys who have been major players with the NSA, as far as the spying issues go. Do you feel like any of that is going to curry them a little bit more favor in saying, like, look, hey, we scratched your back for a very long time. Is there going to be a little bit of payback here?
Well, I don't think that comes into play as much, although it does. It's an issue that we need to be aware of, that there is this very close tie between big government and big corporations in the phone and cable lobby, and it doesn't only impact issues like net neutrality. There's the history of surveillance where they worked with the NSA and handing over metadata. I don't know that they're using that argument to get the FCC to exchange favor and to not go forward with the net neutrality ruling. I know, though, that they are very concerned about this, and if you thought their lobbying over the last couple of years, as you've mentioned, they spent tens of millions of dollars, hundreds of millions of dollars, if you look at their whole record on this, to kill net neutrality. They're going to increase those efforts as in the wake of Obama's statement and as this chairman seems to making some gestures towards accommodating Obama and the public interest. They're very concerned about this, and when AT&T gets angry, when AT&T gets concerned inside Washington, things start to happen. So we're very vigilant about that, and we want to make sure that they don't use the power of their checkbook to force the agency to pass bad policy.
We've got a little under a minute left here. Real quick, what can our viewers do to help support free press and to help keep net neutrality out there in the open?
Well, the first place you can go, of course, is to our website, freepress.net. We have a lot of tools there that people can use, whether they want to call the White House or whether they want to contact Congress, call the FCC. We have tools there that they can use. We also have FAQs and other resources there. We're part of a larger coalition, too. Another website that Free Press is involved with is called battleforthenet.com. We're working with a number of other groups there that have been doing street actions and a lot of other protests. It's going to be a busy couple of months, so if you want to get involved, now would be a good time to do it.
All right. Timothy Karr, thank you very much for everything you do, for everything Free Press does, and hopefully this will be another victory that progressives can celebrate in the coming months. Thank you very much for joining us today.
Thank you. My pleasure.